So let's get it. 2022 gonna be a great year, y'all. And without further ado, everybody, happy Tech Tuesday. I'm excited. I don't know if I wouldn't say intimidation. I don't know. So a little tidbit. Let me step back and talk a little bit about myself before I let her have the stage. If y'all that know me, I've been interested in cybersecurity. I actually was able to break into the field back in September. And up until then, I had joined a few little groups here and there that kind of help people get ready, that kind of put resources out, that do training sessions and whatnot. And this is one that I always was excited in, but because of my nature, I kind of take on too much by myself and try to figure it out alone. I haven't been as active, but it's always been something that I thought was cool. I tell anybody who's interested in it to check it out. I'm going to let her speak about it. I'm just excited. Shout out to Tracy, the InfoSec Sherpa, as well. She made it the connection, so thank you. I'm excited. Without further ado, I'm gonna let Miss Tennisha introduce herself, let her talk about what she has going on, and if you guys have any questions, please feel free to ask. Trent, I appreciate you for coming through again. Y'all have I hope y'all enjoy. All right. How are you?
All right, what's going on? I am good. I am excited because I hear you're a member of the Black Girls Hack Squad.
Hey.
You been lurking?
Yeah, a little lurking, yeah. I've been lurking, guys, sorry.
All right, so I'm the executive director for an organization that is called Black Girls Hack. So we've been around as a nonprofit for about a year, but we've actually been around for like probably closer to two at this point. Just sharing information about people trying to get into cybersecurity, trying to increase diversity in cybersecurity. And like, I'm always shocked whenever I see male members of our squad. I think probably like 25% of our organization are men. But if you hop in our Slack, you know, I feel like, you know, they don't say anything, right? Like they're hiding. Because I was telling Alante, I was like, I feel like it's because, you know, they're men and the organization is called Black Girls Hack. And, you know, he checked me real quick. He was like, nah, that's not it. but we have so many people in the squad that are, you know, not just Black or women or girls. So, like, you know, we're all about anybody who's trying to, you know, get into cybersecurity, that's trying to, you know, do what we're trying to do. You know, so I'm excited to meet you. Shout out to InfoSec Sherpa. She, you know, she's like a key.
Yeah, she really is.
she is definitely my cyber plug. So.
Really? So I took a peep at your LinkedIn. I like to kind of do a little, you know, a little OSINT, a little research myself. But that's kind of just from my, will you talk about your experience? How did you get into IT? How did you get into specifically cybersecurity? You know, what drives you? How did you get where you are now?
So I went to school for electrical and computer engineering. My goal originally when I, you know, started school was that I did not want to be a programmer because my father is a developer, and he was like, you need to be a developer. And I'm like, okay, I'm going to be anything but a developer. So, you know, I went and did that program. And then some point in college, I was like, you know, I want to help people. I want to, like, you know, make a difference in their lives. So at the time, like after I finished my degree, I was like, all right, I'm about to go to medical school. It's crazy because when we talk about people who like switch their careers and, you know, it's just a non-traditional like path into cybersecurity, like that was legit my life.
Nice.
So like I went and did pre-med for a couple years in outside of Philly. And then I applied to medical school and they was like, nah, chill. So I promised myself that, you know, after I spent like a crap load of money on you know, applications to get into med school and MCATs and all of those things, that I was like, if I didn't get in, that I was going to you know, have to go get a job in the real world. Yeah. So I actually got a job in healthcare IT as a consultant at the time. And my job was basically like, you know, when I got in, I'm from Northeast DC. Shout out to Kenilworth. When I got into the school, there was another woman who had gone to the same grad school I did. She did the same program that I did. And then she went into the same company I did. But she was making, you know, my first job was $55,000, my first tech job. And then she got the same exact job with the same exact company, one level higher than me, making $70,000. So I was like, you know, I'm like, you know, $55,000, that's more than most people I know make. So I was like, yo, I'm big balling. Hey. I'm like, it's about to be a hot girl summer.
Yeah.
So, you know, I went in and they were like, you know, hey, well, if you want to get to the next level, you got to get a master's degree that's in something tech related, right? So mind you, I already had a master's in healthcare policy and management, which was the same as the other woman. And then, so I went back to school and I got another degree in IT, another master's in IT.
Nice.
And that was my second master's at the time. And then, you know, at that point, I just started, you know, in the consulting world. You know, I've been in the you know, the DMV area basically since I left, like doing my pre-med outside of Philly. And it's just basically been like, you know, just consulting, just working through, you know, the government, you know, world, trying to level up. And, you know, I was getting certifications and things like that in tech. Mm-hmm. At the time when I started off, I was doing a lot of quality assurance. They called me a consultant, but, you know, functionally I was basically like a sysadmin slash software tester.
Oh, okay. So, like, nice.
I went and got all of the certifications in software testing. I got my PMP. I got, you know, a whole bunch of stuff. And then, you know, at some point I was like, yeah, this is not working for me, right? I'm not feeling challenged. I'm not, you know, I'm not getting what I need.
Yeah, you know, so you're big on the 80-20 rule?
What's that?
So, one sec. TJ, I appreciate the light, man. How you doing? Happy Tech Tuesday. So the 80-20 rule, what a guy described to me, shout out to Eddie Lumpkin, he came on here, and he basically said, and it applies to any aspect of your life, but he related specifically to a job. You know, you're going to, once you learn 80% of a role, the rest of that 20% is so nuanced that it may take 5, 10, 15 years because it's such, like, little things, like maybe political, or it may be something that's not necessarily that somebody that just stepped on the job will learn. It's just the intricacies. So whenever he gets to 80, he feels like he's mastered 80% of a role. At that point, he feels like he's wasting his time. So it's time to either move on or well, that's what it's time to do, to move on at that point. And I don't know, I kind of started applying that to things in my life with certain groups I was in, certain things I was studying for, and certain, again, some jobs as well. Like my last desktop role, you know, within a year or two, I felt like I had mastered that role. And same as you, I was getting bored. I felt like to learn the other 20% of this role, I would just have to be at this position and know this person and know that, and that things that aren't standard operating procedures and so on and so forth. Just the kind of little, you may learn it, you may not. So that's kind of one thing that he taught me that I went out. Jordan Pennington, Bo, appreciate the light, the toxic guys that I love, Tech Tuesdays. Hey, I love you, man. Thanks for coming by. But yeah, that's the 80-20 for real. I'm sorry to cut you off.
Oh, no, you're all good. You know, I don't know. I want to say that's part of it, but then part of it was also me hitting like financial ceilings and me not continuing. Because when I, you know, I was jumping around from, you know, company to company, like after 2 years, I was gone. Like it was like, you know, dip in, you know, grab the bag and then jump, you know, somewhere else for another bag. It's bigger, right? So at some point, you know, I got to the point where I'm applying to other jobs and they're not talking to me, you know, in the way that I want to be talked to, you know, like they were super disrespectful. Like, you know, hey, we want to hire you for, you know, $40,000 less than what I was making 10 years ago, you know, that kind of foolishness.
True.
And, you know, so I was like, all right, you know, when I was younger, I wanted to be a hacker. So I was like, you know, I got a tech degree, you know, I feel like there's not a lot of a big jump between like, you know, the types of stuff that I was doing and like penetration testing. I'm like, I'm about to be a hacker out there.
Hey.
So I just started, like, you know, just grinding, and I'm applying for jobs. I've got, like, you know, stupid amount of degrees, and I'm like, why is it that I'm not getting any callbacks, you know? Like, why is it that I'm not hearing anything back? And, you know, then I started realizing that, you know, I'm still a Black woman named Tennisha in America, you know, because I started finding that, you know, like, I've never put all my degrees on my resume, but, like, I started figuring if I put, you know, less degrees on there, then I was less intimidating.
Wow.
You know, at some point I debated changing my name to my middle name to put on my resume, because my middle name sounded less ethnic. Wow. And I'm thinking, all right, maybe that'll get me, you know, more, you know, callbacks. So, you know, I started looking into things like, you know, how to, you know, what's it called, make your resume more efficient, how to optimize, you know, and, you know, tailor your resume, because it was just like, I wasn't, you know, I wasn't getting the kind of responses that I wanted to get. And then, you know, when I started looking in jobs for cybersecurity, I found that they wanted, you know, certifications or, what is it, job experience, or, what was the third thing? Ooh, education. That was the other thing. So, you know, I have the education piece, but I didn't have, like, the work experience in that area, and I didn't have the certifications in that area, right? So I started working on those things to try to, you know, get my foot in the door. And I realized as I was going through that process that, you know, there are probably people out here who have, you know, not as much degrees, haven't been consulting for 15 years, that don't have that, you know, experience, that are trying to get into cybersecurity. And, you know, they're not trying to pay, you know, stupid money for a certification or, you know, things like that. You know, I started looking at the CEH, and nice. My husband likes to crack jokes at me because, you know, I bought my first CEH voucher and it was like $1,000 at the time, and I failed it. And I went and bought another one, and the retakes were like $600, and I failed it. And my husband was like, you know, so how much you want to just, you know, donate to these people? And I'm like, you know, there are people out here who are probably like, you know, that can't, they can't even, you know, begin to try to pay because they've got, you know, kids or, you know, whatever the situation may be.
That's true.
But then now it's like, you know, we have CEH vouchers with training, and it's like, I think it's $300 or $400, right? But if you go to their website, like, there's still $1,200 for a CEH voucher, right? But it was through, like, connections, people saying to me, like, you know, I was complaining to somebody, like, you know, how are people supposed to be able to get into cyber when you're paying, you know, all of this money for a CEH, you know, voucher, or, you know, any of the other UC councils, not to pick on them. There's a whole bunch of people who are guilty of that.
Guys, CEH stands for Certical Ethical Hacker. It's one of the certifications you can get when you're trying to get into security that kind of just signifies, hey, I know what I'm doing. I can hack this stuff if you keep playing. Third court game, and my guy Corinthian said, blessings, my boy. Shout out to you, man. How you doing? It's good to hear from you. Thank you for stopping by. But, okay, so did you ever, so in I guess in your journey of going to get that cert, is that what inspired you to start Black Girls Hack?
It is, because I realized that people needed, you know, basically a plug. They needed to know that, you know, you don't have to go out here and pay, you know, $1,400. We can do the same thing for much cheaper. And there are organizations that have been out here, like, low key, like, not even like advertising it, like, you know, hey, you don't have to pay $1,400. We sell it for like half of that on our website, you know?
Yep.
And it was like, I didn't have the you know, I mentioned to you before we got started that I'm not real, a real people person, you know? So, like, I'm mostly keep to myself and just do what I need to do. Keep your head down and, you know, get your bag. So, like, I didn't talk to a lot of people, so I wasn't, like, connecting and networking. And I tell people all the time that if you don't have certifications, you don't have experience, you don't have education, you damn well better have a good network.
That's very true.
Because if you don't have a good network, then it's like people like InfoSec Sherpa. You know, Tracy, I can't tell you how many people Tracy has connected. Tracy will drop me a DM on a dime, like, hey, did you see this? Like, are you up on this?
Shout,
like,
out to her again, man. She was a really great guest on here. I really enjoy her.
She's so dope. She's such a dope human. But she's introduced me to so many people. And, you know, I found through, you know, doing Black Girls Hack that, you know, people are out here making it much harder than it has to be. You know, going at it, like, by yourself, you know? And you don't have to do it by yourself. You know, part of the thing, one of the things I love about Black Girls Hack is that, you know, we are a tribe. Like, we've got a whole bunch of people who are encouraging and supporting each other, and are making connections and that are helping each other. And it's not like, you know, some people move based on financial motivations or some people move based on, you know, whatever it is. But I feel like a lot of the people who are there because they want to help.
I agree.
And I love that because, you know, one of the things that I think kind of put me off when I first started trying to get into cybersecurity is one of the people who reached out and they were like, you know, hey, do you need a mentor? Well, go ahead and drop, you know, $100 a month on my Patreon. And
tech scammers.
I was like, wait, what?
Yeah, God.
Like, you gonna mentor, but you wanna charge me, you know, money every month?
Guys, be careful too, y'all at home. If you are trying to break into the field, that is a thing these days. You have a lot of people who tell you that they make an X and Z amount of money and they've been in for not this amount, and if they let them mentor you, you'll be making this, you just gotta drop this fee or this. Like Tennisha said, there are so many free resources. There are so, hers, I look down, after, when we get done, I'm gonna probably just screen share the Slack page and just show you a little bit of stuff. Like, man, there are so many free organizations. That's the thing, and she hit the nail on the head when she was speaking of networking. I think that's another reason why I hadn't been as active within your organization, because I did come in on a very special network, a very good group of people that kind of reach out and make sure I keep my stuff together. So I kind of do have a small little tight-knit circle, but that is definitely important, especially when you're doing something you don't know, because there's going to be people who know more. There's going to be people who've been doing it longer than you. There's going to be people who are smarter than you. One of my favorite quotes is, if you're the smartest person in the room, you're in the wrong room. You know,
no BS.
Straight up, because it's always something that somebody should be. Corinthian, I'm doing amazing, brother. No doubt, been a while. I had the tunnel vision, some things for a second. Good to see you. I'm going to hit you up. Man, hit me up, man. For sure. We do need the link, man. Y'all be sure to check out Third Core Gaming on Twitch and Facebook as well. He's a great producer, gamer, artist, human being. Y'all be sure to check my guy out. The toxic guy said hello to Black Girls Hack.
Hey,
what's good? But okay, sorry.
Yeah, but so you just touched on a little bit. Like, I feel like the whole thing on like tech Twitter right now, and I don't even want to say Black tech Twitter because it's not even like a thing that's specific to us. Is like, hey, I just had a 6-figure month. Let me tell you how you can get into tech without a degree, without a cert, without a, you know, whatever. And, you know, they get 50 people to sign up. Like, that's how you got a six, you know, you're selling $3,000, $4,000 workshops. Because this is people that all they got to do is invest in themselves. And then they get you a 6-week boot camp, come out with still no certification,
exactly.
Still no education, still no none of that. And then, yeah, they made their 6-figure month. But then you're no closer to being able to maintain a career in tech.
Let me sell Black Girls Hacks real quick. And what you get with Black Girls Hack is you don't get that. You get hands-on experience. You get live training. You get a resource. You get people around you who care about your well-being. Y'all better come to Black Girls Hack, man. And it's free. Free.com, free 99, all of that, $0.00 and 0 cents. Look. I don't know. I do appreciate everything you're doing, because what you're saying right now is one of the things that does make it hard for people breaking into the field, because it's like information overload. You know, somebody who, what would you say to somebody? Say we got a viewer right now who's interested in breaking into cybersecurity with no IT experience. What would you say to them?
I say figure out what it is that you want to do and start making the right connections. You know, you can follow a whole lot of hashtags on like Twitter and mm-hmm. LinkedIn. Start connecting with people. Like, I can't tell you, like, of all the people I meet that I have connected with me on like LinkedIn, like, I don't know most of them, but you know, I am more than willing for anybody on the squad to connect somebody with somebody in my network. If, you know, if they're at a job that they want to see, if they're in the position that you're trying to be in, because I feel like, you know, we don't have to go in through the front door. You know,
that's true.
It's stupid trying to go in the front door as, you know, a Black person named Alante or
Tanisha. Let's do that. Let's do something. Let's do a little skit. I'm going to play just like Alante with no IT experience, and I'm going to come to you. I'm just ask you, just say I'm just somebody off the street. I'm too divine with the heart. Hey, happy Tech Tuesday. Glad you stopped by. All right. So, Miss Tanisha, look, I can't keep doing this. I'm tired. I really want to get into IT, but I'm scared. I don't know. I need to learn how to code. What's What do I do?
Like I said, you need to connect with people, try to figure out what it is that you want to do with your career.
Connect where? How do I?
LinkedIn. Start connecting people, like, you know, figure out, like, you know, hey, I think I might be interested in this. I think I might be interested in this. When somebody's super brand new to cybersecurity, what I tell them is to start trying to do, like, a capture the flag, right? Because a capture the flag has, like, that umbrella of activities that you can kind of get involved in, right? It's a little bit of this, it's a little bit of this. Like, it's like going to, like, the Cyber Olympics, right? Yeah. So you can kind of figure out, like, hey, I'm not a coder. I don't even speak that language. But, you know, I really like, you know, password cracking. Or I really like, you know, reverse engineering. Or I really like, you know, whatever it is. You don't have to be a developer. Like I said, I've worked my whole life to not be a developer.
Would you recommend try Hack Me or Hack the Box for Capture the Flags? Or which site? Do you have one better?
I have two. So I would say try Hack Me. It has a free option. And there's also a website that's put out by Carnegie Mellon University. Shout out to my fellow alums. It's called Pico Capture the Flag. So it's a free Capture the Flag site. And you can log in and do, like, challenges. And it's set up basically like a game. Like, beat a challenge. Yep. It's I think it's picoctf.org.
Oh, okay. I do know. Okay, cool. And okay, my guy QM with the drop the link to picoctf. Thank you for coming by, QMX. Yes, sir. And my guy Don't Watch Gaming. Y'all are showing out tonight. Look at y'all.
I would say try Hack Me and Hack the Box try Hack Me and Pico Capture the Flag because they're free, right? Mm-hmm. So once you are at the point where you've got a little bit of skills, like baby skills, then I would suggest doing something like Hack the Box, because the thing with Hack the Box is that it's not expensive, but it's like, it's not as user friendly as Try Hack Me.
Try
Hack Me is like, step one, you're going to do this.
What is a computer?
Are you looking here? And they've got so many tracks. So it doesn't matter if you are interested in being a defender or you're interested in being a ethical hacker or penetration tester, whatever the case may be, Try Hack Me has an option in there. Like, they've got different tracks that you can, you know, just practice your skills. Okay. You know, so there's also another organization I like to use called Pentester Labs, and Range Force also. The benefits. Yeah, we've actually got a partnership with Range Force. So for our members, I want to say our paid members, because we just actually put out at the end of last year a paid membership.
For Black Girls Hack?
Yeah, for Black Girls Hack.
Okay, I need to get on.
It's $49 a year, basically, but you can still be in there for free. You don't have to pay for membership, but people who have the paid membership, they get a free membership to Range Force, so they can practice those skills, and that's a lot of routine things. So if you're interested in defense, or not to mention that it gets you an extra $50 off of all of our certification vouchers.
So for $49 a month, guys, we can be a part of.
Let me keep selling this for you. I like this.
It's not even $49 a month. It's $49
a year. For guys, all right. So let's think about all we spend $49 on a month. Now think about.
Look, that's my DoorDash order just now.
You know what I'm saying? You could save that, and you could put that towards something that'll help you eat for the rest of your life. Help your family eat. Help your family's family eat.
Yeah, cook in today. You know.
Yeah. Okay. So look, I'm definitely enjoying this. I would definitely love to have you back if you think that's an option.
Absolutely. I would definitely. Circle back around. We could talk about something, you know, not just, you know.
Yeah, we'll break it down and go into some specific chat. Do y'all have anything to ask? Y'all are really going in tonight. I appreciate y'all for coming by. I do want to talk for a little bit, though. So my whole thing, guys, you know, I started this Tech Tuesday last year, and I won't say that I didn't have a direction with it, but I was kind of just freestyling, just finding people who would talk back to me. I love this. Thanks, Trent. I'm glad you enjoyed it. And we'll kind of just go through it. This, for real, gets better every week. Yeah, I agree. This has been one of my favorites. But moving forward, I kind of want to make sure that I'm giving you guys content that you can move forward and do something with instead of just enjoying the show. Like, it's okay to enjoy this. I definitely enjoy y'all. I love y'all to death. But I want to make sure that I'm doing more of a service towards y'all. So be on the lookout this year we're doing a home lab series. I'm going to be showing how I set up my home lab. We're going to be doing a series with the smart mirror that I'm working on. And we're also going to be going into, like, in-depth topics. So What I'm going to do is when I start throwing these on YouTube, what I need y'all to do, if there are any specific questions that y'all have, go into the YouTube and start asking them, and I can just put together a little video specifically on what y'all want to know. Aside from that, be looking towards the YouTube, because we're going to fill that content up on there this year. We're going to go crazy on YouTube. And the goal is by the end of the year to get off Facebook. I'm tired of Facebook.
I had to break up with them.
I stream to Facebook. That's the only reason I still have it. I'm tired of Facebook though.
Yeah, so. We used to go together, you know, me and Facebook back in the day. I was one of her early adopters. But you know, like I'm real big on like my privacy, like my private information not being like sold to the highest bidder.
Yes.
And like, you know, I started peeping things, and you know, people who had my information that I didn't give it to them before I even got there. Cause like I put a bogus birthday in Facebook, and then all these people had this bogus birthday. Huh. And the only place I used that birthday was Facebook. So I was like, Facebook is out here pimping my information.
Facts.
That's fine. We broke up. It was amicable. But I would also say, if you have people who are more interested in tech, like if you're trying to learn how to code, there's a website called Code Academy.
Yes.
And I want to say, you can, if you're a student, you can get it for like $30 for 3 months, and I think everybody else it might be like maybe $20 or $30 a month.
Guys,
but, you know,
I'm gonna say, if you have a .edu account, even if you work at a university, y'all better be using that, because you get a lot of perks on websites. Even if you're not an active student, if you have a edu account, guys, please use that. Take advantage of it.
And I'm going to drop a key. I've said this before, but a lot of people don't know. Go get a library card. The public library gets you access to, I think it's like LinkedIn Learning and Udemy courses for free.
I didn't know that.
People out here, every time Udemy buy a, you know, have a sale, they're like, I'm going to buy all of these courses. And, you know, I myself probably got like 50 courses and I probably haven't even cracked open yet for, you know, $10 here, $10 there. Like, I need to learn this, right? But then, you know, come to find out, if you got a public library card, that you can actually use that.
Wow.
And for the most part, you know, those library cards are free. So it's like, you know, you can... And if you're a vet, I just found out that if you're a vet, you can get access to LinkedIn Learning for a year for free also. So, like, there are opportunities out here, but you wouldn't know that unless you start talking to other people who are trying to move in the same space. So, you know, I'd say if you take nothing else from, you know, the City Boy Summer podcast, that you, you know, get you a network, get you a group of people who you can speak to about what it is that you're doing, because I can't tell you... I can't emphasize this enough, that it's important that you have people that you can actually, you know, bounce ideas off. Like, this is what I'm trying to do. And they understand what it is that you're doing.
Agreed.
You know? Cause like most of my best friends are, my day ones are not in tech. So when we talk about things, we'll talk about how many widgets you got going on, or how many, we talk about things in very generic terms that everybody can kind of understand. But like, if I want to bounce something off, like, hey, I'm thinking about this kind of thing, or I'm thinking about hacking this, or I'm thinking about doing this. You know, I have people in the squad that I can talk to and, you know, just basically just circulate ideas. And, you know, I have a group chat on my phone. One of the good sisters just got a, you know, 100% remote job with all of the perks and benefits, you know, and I was like, you know, I wanted that for you.
Yes.
You need a group of people that, you know, are trying to help elevate you. If your friends aren't pushing you to do bigger and better, you need new friends.
I heard
you know?
That. And I'll piggyback off that. My guy that came and dropped the link to Pico CTF, I won't give his personal name out. He is a very behind-the-scenes type dude. But that's probably been – I can speak to that network. Having people in your network that understand the lingua you used to. Because, you know, I love my family, but when I first started in tech, you know, I would be sitting at the computer – crying some nights trying to understand, what is subnetting? What's the function? You know, trying to get... And I called my grandma and she'd be like, you know, baby, you just got to pray. And yes, I do, but there's so... You got to have somebody that can talk to this, you know, that can speak to this with you. So I'm so thankful for my circle, man. My guy, QMX, I won't speak your real name. You my boy. You know, I love you to death. All my people at work, all my people that hang out with me and listen to me talk this nonsense, man, thank y'all. But don't watch Game and say she's speaking. She is preaching. She definitely got to come back, right? I'm so glad y'all enjoyed this. He said, this is the real Tech Tuesday. It is. I'm too divine, said I need to get a library card again, right? Look, I told y'all I was excited. I knew she was gonna come in and drop some knowledge. I was just nervous. But
it's all right. Like you know, people who talk to me, they'll realize that like I'm a very down to earth person.
Hold on,
like,
and shout out. Let me give you some kudos real quick. Didn't you just speak at a Sam's event?
I did.
You did? Okay, guys, hold up. All right, so Sam's was one of the big vendors within the IT industry, specifically security. And for Ms. Tennisha to have this organization for less than, you know, 2 years, 2-3 years, and to be able to go speak at an event like that is phenomenal.
Yo, that is
phenomenal.
Not to toot my horn or anything.
Toot it,
but
man,
toot
it. Yeah.
I did a keynote at Sam's, okay? And I also spoke at DEF CON last year.
So wow.
Last year was major. Shout out to Black for Cybersecurity. They made that that happen. But like, that's what I'm telling you. Like, your network is key, because it's people that I have met who have been like, hey, I work at Sands. What's up? I'm hard. So hey, we going to DEF CON. What's up? Like,
that is
you rolling? And I'm like, yeah, I'm rolling. So
okay.
It's not so much what you know as much as you know who you know, because like I mentioned before, like, Tennisha and Alante going through the front door is a problem. You know what I'm saying?
Now.
But through the side door or through the back door, get you a mentor or a sponsor or an ally. Speaking of allies, shout out to Share the Mic and Cyber. If you're trying to do cybersecurity and you are a Black person, I would suggest that you get involved in this program.
Share the Mic.
Program, Share the Mic and Cyber. It is the brainchild of Camille Stewart and Caitlin Ringrose. And they do it twice a year. I think it's in March and October. And for that day, they have an ally, basically a white person. You take over their social media page for a day. One of my good sis from Black Girls in Cyber, Talia took over the CIA director's social media pages for a day. Which is like, I can't explain to you. Like, I got chills just now just thinking about it, because when you see like the CIA director basically, you know, have her picture on there and she's tweeting, you know, talking about her work all day. Like, I can't tell you how major that is. And that was possible by Share the Mic and Cyber. Their goal is basically to amplify the voices of Black people in cybersecurity. So if you were just trying to increase your brand, you know, whether that be a podcast, whether that be your business, whatever it is, like, 2022 is your year.
We got to bring this to an end, because you're dropping too many bombs right now. I'm in bomb overload right now. Okay, share them. Oh, man, guys, thank y'all again. We're going to wrap it up. We end up talking y'all heads off all night. Man, look, I probably will, after I wrap this up, come back with a little gaming. That's pretty. I'll probably come back with a little gaming. We'll see how we feeling. A little bit of everything. I'm so glad you asked. This year, I'm going to pretty much focus on, like, survival games. So, like, games where you drop in with nothing and you got to build and survive the elements and down the month, all product stuff like that. So, we'll probably do that. Stream. I love y'all. I'll be back in like 30 minutes. Don't watch gaming and say I'm getting so inspired. That's what it's about. That's what it's about. Stream, please. I got y'all. Y'all give me like 30 minutes. Let me wrap up this. I got to talk to her off stream, because she has dropped so much valuable information. This has been my favorite one. We'll be back next Tuesday. If I don't have a guest, I got to work on getting some more guests on the schedule right now. If I don't have a guest, we'll just do some chart hack me practice or some coding practice or something. We'll just mess around. But regardless, I will see y'all again before next Tuesday. I love y'all.